on the run with a machine gun. And now all new tonight, police have released the man's name, his photo, and they need everyone's help to bring him in. Action News reporter Kelly Brennan tonight with the manhunt still going on, Kelly, as we speak.
Tonight, police don't know where that suspect is, but they do know he is dangerous. And now, more than 12 hours after the initial SWAT situation, that suspect is still on the run. Pittsburgh police are asking you take a look at this man and be aware he is armed and dangerous. 27-year-old Neil Joseph Harris of Uptown is 6 feet tall, 180 pounds, and is wanted for allegedly making threats near the West Oakland neighborhood. It all started early Tuesday morning. Police say a woman went to a DeRodge Street apartment building looking for a man she says assaulted her niece. She did not find him, but police say she came face to face with an angry Harris, who she claims was holding a machine gun.
He brandished what the victim described as a small machine gun, and he started threatening to shoot everyone.
That's when police and SWAT team members made their way in, using robots to enter the apartment in a state police helicopter overhead.
The victim and another witness bystander actually reportedly saw him on the roof.
But he was never found. Every apartment unit was checked and cleared. Nearby, the Hines Family Center quickly became a concern.
Parents started coming to the scene because it's a daycare and there are children inside.
Everyone was ordered to stay inside. No one was hurt, but the suspect is still on the run. According to online documents, Harris has a record. Most recently, in 2009, he faced felony charges for aggravated assault. Now he's wanted for several charges, including terroristic threats. And if you see him, you are urged to stay away. He is considered armed and dangerous. If you know anything about his whereabouts or where he may be headed, you are urged to contact police immediately. Reporting live tonight from Pittsburgh Police Headquarters, I'm Kelly Brennan, Channel 4 Action News.